All right, today we're going to be taking a look at this septic tank. For those of you who don't know, that most septic systems will have two components at minimum. You're going to have your tank over here, and you're going to have your absorption system over there. The goal of the septic tank is to capture the solids to prevent any of that debris from getting into the drain fields. The drain field's goal is to deal with the liquids. As we can see right here, we have our clean out on the front. This is going to be sitting right over top of the front inlet line, which we can see right in here. Right, so that's going to be the pipe that comes from the house, where every time you flush a toilet, run a sink, bathtub, you name it, all that debris is going to come into here. The reason this exists is in case something gets stuck in the front baffle or gets stuck in the pipe, you have a way of unsticking whatever it is, whether it be through using a rod or using some kind of jetter or snake. Over here in the middle, we're going to see that we have a manhole riser. This thing is designed to make it to where when you pump the tank, you can lift that lid and you're dead center over top of the system. You'll be able to pump all four corners of the septic tank through here. As we can see, the riser has shifted a little bit, so some soil is getting in there. So we're going to recommend that the homeowner consider replacing this old riser with a more modern watertight unit. In the back of the tank, we're going to have this thing called a baffle. The back baffle, its job is to keep all the floating stuff and the debris from getting into the pipe over to the distribution box. The baffle is literally just a shield that prevents all the floating stuff from getting into the pipe. In the tank itself, you're going to have three layers of separation. You're going to have the sludge at the bottom, the effluent in the middle, and the scum up top. The scum is going to be all your fats, hair, oil, greases, toilet paper, etc., and all the heavier debris will fall to the bottom as sludge. The goal of the back baffle is to prevent any of the floating stuff from getting in. Over time, concrete baffles will fall off. As you can see, this one is concrete. One day, the sewer gas is going to just corrode that to where it just falls off, and then you're going to replace it with PVC. From there, we're going to go to a thing called a distribution box. It's a little tiny box that will slow down the water as it disperses into the drain field lines. The distribution box generally will last about 20 years in this area. As you can see, we've got some trees near this box, so we just have to be mindful of roots, but usually they last for almost as long as the drain fields last. So when you replace the drain fields, usually you'll replace the distribution box. The drain fields are going to be trenches, right? So in this area, these trenches are going to be about 2 feet wide, 6 feet deep, and they're about 50 foot each in total run. As you can see, they're about separated by about 10 foot. That's pretty standard in our area. So as the water goes into the distribution box, it'll work its way into the beginning portion of the trench. And then the trench is going to be built with number 2 limestone and a perforated pipe in there. They're going to backfill it with this topsoil. As the water goes through the pipe, it will then work its way into the stone. The stone just opens up the soil to allow the wastewater room to move. And then from there, it'll just percolate its way into the soil, and then nature will do its thing to clean up that nasty water. Over here, generally what will happen is the drain fields will eventually start to fill up with water, which is why you have these observation ports on the end. These ports exist, so that way if you're starting to have issues with your drain field lines, you can pop them open and you can see how full of water the trenches are. You're only going to really see that in our area starting in the middle 2010s, like 2015, 2016. Anything before that, very unlikely to have those kind of observation ports. Your area might be slightly different in what's required by code compared to ours.